us. We break the communion. We look at some word, and after little exhortation, we take the communion. When we take the communion, we come back for the time of prayer. We are going to pray today. He said, we have been praying before. Yes, amen. God bless you, man. I should repeat myself. We have shared these basic principles of communion. After that, we go straight into a little exhortation about communion. The benefit, what the blood of Jesus Christ can do for you, in you, through you. We look at them. After that, we break the communion. After breaking the communion, we come back and take some series of prayer. And after that, God is saying we should pray for the two set of people, those who are believing God for healing and those who are believing God for fruit of the womb. Throughout this program, I will be praying for them every blessed day. And after that, I will come and we stretch our hands toward our prayer request. We pray on it. If you have sent in your prayer request is there, we pray on it. God will surely answer us in the name of Jesus. If you have not done that, why not send it in? But it's too late for today. What you just need to do is rest up your hand, or when you just write it down, stretch it up. When we are praying on them, we pray on it and send it immediately after this program. Amen. If you need the link, why not send a message to that number on the screen, +234 806268 6255, and I will send you the link. Amen. Let's not forget, today is Friday. Our weekly Fiji hold tonight on Conference Call Lab. God bless us in the name of Jesus. Once again, my name is Ariola Oreolua, the prayer coordinator of the online prayer ministry, Praying Eagles Network, from Lagos State, Nigeria. Amen. Somebody asked the other time that, where are you from? Lagos State, Nigeria. God bless us. Six basic principles of Holy Communion. Sweet Holy Spirit, I ask that, Father, you come and breathe upon this table as you go into your word, as you begin to share what the blood of Jesus, the efficacy in the blood of Jesus, the power, the benefit of the blood of Jesus. I ask that we look at them, that we begin to honor it in our life in Jesus' name. Six basic principles of Holy Communion. What are the six basic principles of Holy Communion? Before you can take Holy Communion, before you can speak for you, before you can work for you, what are the principles that guide it? Number one, you must be born again. Number one, you must be born again. You must be born again. Romans 10:9 Amen. And say, if you confess with your mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord and you believe in your heart, so you must confess him with your mouth and believe in your heart. Number one, you must believe and accept Jesus Christ, be born again, accept him as your personal Lord and Savior. Number two, communion can be taken any day of the week. Any day of the week. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Any day of the week. Any day of the week, you can take communion. Acts 2:46. Number three, communion can be taken any time of the day. In the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening, in the night. Any time of the day. Hear me and hear me very well. Quote me anywhere. Communion can be taken any time of the day. Midnight hour, you can take communion. Early in the morning, you can take communion. Late in the night, you can take communion. Amen. 1 Corinthians 11:25-26. Number four, communion can be taken anywhere. Yes, you hear me right. Anywhere. Some people say it should be in the church. No, there's nowhere that says it should be in the church. Amen. Communion can be taken anywhere. In your house, in your office, in your shop. Amen. When you're having a family meeting, you can break communion. Amen. You see that in Acts 2:46. Number five, who can administer communion? As today now, I'm the one to administer communion. What right did I have? What audacity did I have to administer communion? What legal right, spiritual legal right, do I have to administer communion? Amen. Revelation 1:6. The Bible says, and has made us kings and priests unto the living God. Jesus Christ, the day I gave my life to Christ, the day I received his ordination, amen, the day I accept this ministry, his assignment, amen, what happened that day? He made me a king and a priest. So the only person that can administer communion is a priest. A king cannot administer communion. It's a spiritual thing. But a priest can administer communion. Hear me and hear me very well. The day you gave your life to Christ, yes, you hear me. You are saying, because you are a pastor. Yes, I'm a pastor. But there's another aspect of it, of being a priest. The day you gave your life to Christ, God, Jesus Christ, made you a priest that day. Because you are a priest, you can administer communion. Praise the Lord. And last but not the least, what are the material for communion? What are the material that you and I can use for communion? Praise the Lord. Matthew 26, 26 to 28. As they were eating, he took the bread, he broke it and gave it to them. As they were eating, he took the bread, break it. Amen. I always share with people, it's not a special bread. As they were eating, the bread they were eating, he took it. He blessed it and break it. So what do you have in your house? You have a loaf of bread or sliced bread. In my area, they call some bread, agege bread. Amen. Praise the Lord. Whatever kind of bread, either wheat bread. And if not, if God help you, you have this special material, they call it communion wafer. Communion wafer. Communion wafer. Amen. You are blessed. Oh, glory be to God. Make use of it. And if not, do you have biscuit in your house? Biscuit for your children. Or you have cookies. My sister, please bring them out from the fridge. Amen. You have cake. Amen. For those of us who always have cake in our fridge, please bring the cake out. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Bring the cake out. Amen. We share it. Amen. It's part of joy. Amen. Oh, thank you, Jesus. God is saying, I'm giving somebody this year birthday. You are going to celebrate it in an unusual way. You have been celebrating birthday before. But this year is going to be different because it's going to be of joy. It's going to be of joy. It's going to be of joy. The way you will celebrate it this year, it will be totally different. You will look back and say, wow, it's like you have life have just started with you. Amen. This year, birthday, write it down. Write it down. This year, birthday, year 2021, God is saying, it's going to be of joy. It's going to be of joy because something new is going to begin in your life. It's going to begin your life. And this year, birthday is going to be birthday for joy. Tag it like that. Birthday for joy. Amen. I celebrate with that person. Well, I receive it for myself. Amen. And he took the water. What do you have? What is the drink in your house? You have a special wine. I always tell people, not alcoholic wine. Please, don't make use of alcoholic wine. Don't make use of beer. Don't make use of... Amen. So you have soft drink. I don't want to begin to mention any brand. Amen. You have soft drink. You have fruit juice. Please bring them out. And if you don't have anything, you are in the office, you have a cup of water, please bring out your bottle water. We make use of it. We pray on it. We bless it. And God will honor it in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. So these are the six basic principles that guided communion. Six basic principles that guided communion. The Lord bless us in the name of Jesus. Amen. Today, as I said, we look at some of the things, some of the benefits of the communion. And after that, we take the communion and we pray. We look at some of the benefits. And after that, we take the communion and we begin to pray. Amen. Sweet Holy Spirit, once again, I yield myself unto you and I ask that you speak through me in the name of Jesus. And as the word is coming, let it flow into those medium, to those material before your children. And by the time they begin to take it, they are not taking ordinary bread. They are not taking ordinary wafer. They are taking your flesh. They are not drinking ordinary drink. They are not taking ordinary water. They are not drinking ordinary wine, but they are taking your blood. And let it have impact in the name of Jesus. Amen. What are the things? What are the benefits of the blood of Jesus? What are the things? If I'm taking the blood of Jesus, what are the benefits that I can derive from them? Listen to me, there are many, but we run through of them. Number one, you know, we are talking about the dew of heaven, which means the blessings of heaven coming down. What justifies you for you to receive the blessing? The Bible said, and Joshua the high priest stood before their God, and the accuser of the brethren was beside him. Listen to me, there are some of our benefits, there are some of our blessings. Each time heaven releases them, the accuser of the brethren are there to stand against us, to say, no, you are not qualified for them, to say, no, you cannot receive them. Why? Because there are some altar, satanic altar of idolatry in our foundation. And the Bible says, a bastard must not come to the throne up to the 10th generation. A bastard must not come to the throne up to the 10th generation. Listen, this day when we are talking about spiritual bastard, we are not talking about somebody, a child that was given out of wedlock. We are talking about generation who did not serve God. 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 There is a curse upon them. Up to the Bible says, I will bear their iniquity up to the 3rd and the 4th generation. If your father did not serve God, If your great grandfather did not serve God, if you're up to the third, the fourth generation, and he said, Pastor, that means somebody who is outside wedlock, wedlock with God, who is not in agreement with God, will not come to the throne, to the tabernacle, up to the tenth generation. Yes, you can think about it. Your father, your grandfather, your great grandfather, your great great, up to 10 generations. Did all of them serve God? If one of them did not serve God, which we know that for us to see five generations, we are not talking about our children, great grandchildren, but me, my father, oh, please. So there are things that will hinder it. There are things that will make the enemy to say, no, you are not qualified for it. But listen to me. Romans 5, verse 9. Much more than having now been justified by the blood of Jesus. Oh, the Lord is not qualified for this. Listen to me. Even this assignment, I'm not qualified for it. To minister, to carry Bible and talk about the name of Jesus Christ, I'm not qualified. I know I'm not qualified. Well, you know me, my past. You tell people that Odell is not qualified because of his past. But hear me, in that Romans 5 verse 9, it said much more. Have you now been justified? Have you now? Yesterday was not qualified for the blessing. Yesterday, as a result of his deed, his past, he was not qualified. Oh, as a result of iniquity in his father's house, this guy is not qualified for heavenly blessing. But now, somebody say now. I can't hear you. He said, but now, having been justified. Yesterday, I'm not justified, I'm not qualified. But today, having been justified by the blood of Jesus. What is the meaning? By the blood of Jesus, I am justified to receive the heavenly blessing. I am justified. What about you, sir? What about you, man? Praise the Lord. If that one is the only thing that you hold on to today, I say, by the blood of Jesus, I am justified to receive my healing, to receive my blessing, to receive my promotion. You are justified in the name of Jesus. Number two, Ephesians 1:7. In him, we have redemption through what? Through his blood, the forgiveness of sins. Whatever is my past, you know, we say past. Whatever is my sin, that the things of the past. So the Bible says, by the blood of Jesus, I'll be forgiven. So if any man, if any power, if any principality, if the hell is still holding on to that, they are joking. You know why they are joking? Because I'll be forgiven by the blood of Jesus. I'll be forgiven. Sin, open doors for attack. Sins, repair blessing. Sins, hindered breakthrough, but being justified and being forgiven, I have access to them. And every door of attack will be closed. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Somebody say thank you, Jesus. So today, listen to me. Your past, which are the sins of the past or generational sins, God has forgiven you and you have been redeemed back by the blood of Jesus. Somebody shout hallelujah. Listen to me. Let me quickly share this. If God forgives totally, it is a man that will forgive you, and tomorrow will be still be using it against you. Somebody, I have issue with somebody some years ago. You know what he said? And he said, that was how you did this thing to me. So that time, and that thing that he was making reference to, it was exactly 11 years. And we have settled. I went somewhere. He said, I shouldn't have gone. I should have followed him to his own place. And I said, oh, I don't know. I'm sorry, sir. And we are journeying town. And after 11 years, he still make reference to it. That was how you went to somewhere. That is the woman before you. But when God forgive you, he forgives totally. Why am I saying this? The moment you receive forgiveness of sin, every repercussion of those sins must come to an end. So if that is the case, why is devil and his host still buffeting you, still attacking you, still attacking your marriage, your finance, your home? Why are you still suffering? Why are you still under that affliction? Today, by the blood of Jesus, because you have been forgiven and because you have been justified, and hand come to that attack in the name of Jesus, attack of the mind, attack of the brain, attack on your finance, attack on your marriage, any attack physically, spiritually, maritally, and hand come to them today in the name of Jesus. Just like Romans 5:9 said, much more than having now been justified by his blood, we shall be saved from wrath through him. Any wrath, repercussion of the sin, whatever you have done yesterday in the time of unknown, that you are paying the price, whatever your parents have done, that your generation are paying the price. Now, have you been justified and you have been forgiven? He said, you shall be saved from that wrath. You shall be saved from that wrath. You shall be saved from that wrath. So I prophesy again, because you have been forgiven and because you have been justified, any of those wraths, that means any of those the repercussion of those sins, the attack that entered into your life as a result of those sins, today and hell come to them in the name of Jesus. Oh, I love this. I love this. I love this. Joel 3:21. He said, for I will cleanse their blood that I have not cleansed, for the Lord dwell in Zion. What is the meaning? By the blood of Jesus, the purging blood of Jesus, what will happen? He said, he will purge my blood. What is in my blood that is going to purge? You are asking. Everything in the father, in the mother, will be passed through blood to unborn child. Am I right? When you are talking about DNA, you say everything, the good, the bad, the ugly in the life of their parents will be in their blood. That is why if your parents have eyes problem, the tendency that you are going to have eyes problem is 100%. When you see somebody with arthritis, go and verify either the mother or the father must have arthritis. Amen. So whatever sickness, whatever ailment in the life of your mother, listen to me, you know 100% is in your blood. It's in your blood. I was talking about one of my children, and I said, I know it's you. I was telling her, it's you. Why? There's one of my children. Everything about her is just me. She smiles, she laughs, everything should just be lively. Amen. And there's another one. That one will just be observing you like this. She can observe you for 1 year and not talk. And you think that one did not talk. Hey, when she come to the house, she will analyze you. Amen. And that is my wife. My wife may be in a place for 1 year and will not talk. But let her come to the house. I said, my husband, you see that person? She said it. No, she's wrong. I said, why not talk there? I said, me talk. You know, it's you that is. Amen. Praise the Lord. Everything, the traits, the character, the facial, everything about our parents are being transferred to us. So every negative things in their life too, they are transferring to us. Where our parents fail, listen to me, we too will fail there. Let's not deceive ourselves. It will fail there. Because everything, we inherit it from them. We inherit sickness. As you inherit the will of your father, you inherit the bad thing. But here the Bible is saying, hear me very well. The Bible is saying that by the blood, it will cleanse your blood. Every trait, negative trait, those things that you inherit in your parent that did not give value your life, those sickness, those ailments, those negative character, those negative vices, those things that your husband inherit is you yourself. Your husband is so, permit me, is so stubborn or so arrogant. And when you look at him, at the beginning, you want to go and report to your mother-in-law. But before you talk, your mother said, his son is good. If you know his father, don't worry. Each time you report this, your husband, to your mother-in-law or to the auntie, they will just tell you, don't worry. Your mother-in-law will tell you, if God is there to help me, he will help you too. Because they know. His son is small. The father-in-law, when he's angry, his eye, fire will be coming out. Amen. Hear me and hear me very well. All these negative vices, negative character, negative things in our blood that we inherit from our parents, Today, by the blood of Jesus, heaven will purge them in the name of Jesus. They shall be purged. 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 They shall be purged in the name of Jesus. John 5, 55 to 59. John 5, 55 to 59. John 6. The book of John, chapter 6, 55 to 59. It made us to know that we have eternal life through the blood of Jesus. We have eternal life through the blood of Jesus. So when you have eternal life through the blood of Jesus, what is that thing? What is that attack that want to kill you? What is that sickness that is buffeting you? Who is that power? Who is that entity that is saying you will die suddenly? Hear me and hear me very well. You have eternal life through the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus Christ is in you, and his life is in you. So no one can kill him. So you cannot be killed. Say, I hear. So why are you scared? In the name of Jesus, you will not be killed in the name of Jesus. I say you will not be killed in the name of Jesus. I love this. Leviticus 17:11. Made us to know that we are healed by the blood of Jesus. We are healed by the blood of Jesus. What area of your life do you need healing? Physical healing? Or your marriage is sick? Or is it your business that is sick? The definition of sickness is something that did not work well. If your body organ did not work well, that body organ is sick. Am I right? If you are having headache, the head is not functioning well, the head is sick. If the hand cannot work very well, the hand is sick. If there's problem with your reproductive organ, you are not able to give birth at the right time, that means that reproductive organ is sick. Am I right? So if your marriage did not perform well, what happened to your marriage? The marriage is sick. If your business is not performing well, it's not booming, it's not bringing money. My sister, your business must boom, because you must. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hear me and hear me very. The Bible says, by the blood of Jesus, we are healed. Today, any area of your life that is sick, amen. Today, they shall be healed in the name of Jesus. Colossians 1 verse 20. It says, we have peace with God. We have peace with God by the blood of Jesus. When you have peace with God, there will be peace in every area of your life. When you share the story of Samuel and the story of our Lord Jesus Christ, Luke 1:52, and the book of Samuel, they talk about these two people. They say, Jesus Christ obtained favor with God and with men. What about Samuel? He obtained favor with God and with men. The moment you obtain favor with God, all everything in creation will favor you. So the moment you obtain peace with your creator, all that thing that God created, amen, they will obey God. And because you obtain peace with him, there will be peace. In your marriage, you need peace. You get it through the blood of Jesus. What about your head? What about that child? What about your spouse that is giving you headache? And you have tried all things possible. You don't know what to do again. What you just need to do, my sister, my brother, is to just hold on to the blood of Jesus. Because the Bible says, by the blood of Jesus, we have peace with God. By the blood of Jesus, we have peace with God. Amen. Colossians 1:20. Today, by the blood of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, you are going to obtain peace with God in the name of Jesus. And the moment you obtain peace with God, every other thing in creation, every other thing around you will begin to give you peace in the name of Jesus. Amen. Two more. Zechariah 9:11 made us know that we are delivered by the blood of Jesus. You and I are delivered. Delivered from what? Delivered from negative vices. Delivered from satanic oppressor. Delivered from things that are buffeting us. Delivered from power that are greater than us in our father's house, in our mother's house, in our environment, in our in-laws' house, even where we work. Those leaders that are saying, no, you don't get it. Oh, you don't bow down for me. But God is saying, we are delivered today in the name of Jesus from those things that are oppressing us, from those things that are harassing us, from those people that are tormenting us. Heaven, deliver us in the name of Jesus. Deliver our marriage, deliver our business, deliver our career in the name of Jesus. A lot. I have more than 60 things area which the blood of Jesus can do. Let me give us one more so that we go to breaking it. Colossians 2:15. Having the same principalities and power, he made a public spectacles, public shows of them, triumphing over them in victory. What is the meaning? by the blood of Jesus, you are able to come out from the area of darkness to the limelight of God. You don't understand. When we are talking about darkness, sickness is darkness. Poverty, darkness. Disease, darkness. Lack, darkness. Anything that did not bring glory to God is darkness. So, but the Bible says, by the blood of Jesus, you and I, we are able to come, move from the kingdom of darkness to the kingdom of light. You know why? Because we are being redeemed. I've told us, what the redemption come from the word redeem. And redeem simply means to buy back. Amen. Something that belongs to you, something that belongs to your generation, but somebody lost it or you sold it out, but you need to pay price to have it back. So he used his own blood to pay it so that you can receive it back. So he redeemed you back. He buy you back with his own blood from the kingdom of darkness. So if you have been bought back from the kingdom of darkness, your marriage, your business, your career, your health, your finance, your children, your man, everything about you. So why is devil still buffeting you? Why is devil still attacking you? Why is devil still harassing you? Today we are going to lift up that cup of the blood of Jesus as a sign, as a ticket to show him enough is enough. Remove your hand, remove your leg from my marriage, from my business, from my health. And today, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ on Nazareth, the blood will speak. It will speak victory. It will speak liberation. It will speak justification in the name of Jesus. But before we go into the time of prayer or to break the communion, if you don't have Jesus Christ in your life, you know, I said six basic principles of Holy Communion. The first one is for you to give your life to Jesus Christ. If you don't give your life to Jesus Christ, don't deceive yourself. Or you gave him sometimes ago, and when things are, you borrow it back. Amen. And things are not, listen to me, you just need to surrender totally back to him. My life was upside down in those days. My life was, if there's another word for upside down, but when I gave my life to Christ, he promised that he will fine tune my life. And today I can see his glory. I can see his honor. I can see his hand in my life. I can see it. I can testify on a daily basis. I was once a prisoner before. Prisoner of faith. Prisoner in the hands of devil. Prisoner in the sense that the devil used me the way he liked. I was once that I will not enter church. I was someone that would take Bible and would begin to tear it. Tear Bible. Yes, I mean it. This Bible, I begin to tear it. Amen. I will use it to do kites. I will use it to fly. We call it aeroplane in those days. Because anything called Jesus, anything called Bible, I hate it. And I will tell people there is nothing. I will tell Bible, I will tell you there is nothing we do. I will even set it on fire. There is nothing we do. But I met him one day. I surrendered unto him. He changed my life. He added value to my life. He added beauty to my life. He added glory to my life. He removed sweat and struggle from my life. In those days, it's always bitterness. But me, this day, you see me smiling. You see me smiling all the time. Because I added joy to my life. I invite you to accept Jesus Christ into your life too, my brother. So that the season of sweat and struggle will come to an end. So that his blood, as we are taking it today, will be able to speak for you. Are you ready? It's just a simple thing. I didn't ask me to bring fowl or anything. He just said, just lay hand on your chest. I lay hand. And he just said a simple prayer. And I said, is that all? He said, is that all? It's like magic and it worked. And it's going to work for you today in the name of Jesus. Are you ready? So just lay your hand on your chest. If you are giving your life to Christ, but you borrow it back, but you want to transfer it back, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Just do the same thing. Lay hand on your chest as I pray for you. Father, say, Father, in the name of Jesus, repeat after me. Say, in the name of Jesus, say today, say, I've come before you. Say, as a wretched sinner, say, I repent and I forsake. Say, I've come before you, Jesus, and I accept you as my personal Lord and Savior. Say, I invite you to my life. Come into my life. Come and reign and rule. Take over. Be in charge of every area of my life. Thank you, mighty Father. Blessed be your name. Say, sweet Holy Spirit, from today, I invite you to my life. Come and reign and rule. Jesus' name. As you have said that in the name of Jesus, I ask, let the Spirit of the Lord God breathe upon you in the name of Jesus, and let the Lord himself begin to speak to you, begin to walk in you in the name of Jesus. Every negative vices in your life, let the Lord God put an end to it in the name of Jesus. Every attack of the devil, every grips of the devil over your life, let God break it in the name of Jesus. Let your season of new day, season of new time, let it come in the name of Jesus. Today, as you have declared and declared Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, I ask, it's for a special gift from heaven. Let God release it unto you in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, the rest, are we ready to take the communion now? So, my brother, you cannot be part of us. You can take communion now and you see the wonders in the blood. Amen. Just stretch it out as I pray on those communion. Lift it up as I pray on them. Father, in the name of Jesus, today, as you have gathered before your throne of mercy, I ask that you breathe upon this table in the name of Jesus. Sanctify them in the name of Jesus. As you partake of this, let it bring life. Let it bring life in the name of Jesus. Thank you, mighty Father. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' name, we have decreed. In Jesus' name, we have decreed. Amen. You take the flesh and you take the blood. Amen. Can you serve yourself? Amen. Take the flesh first and you take. Take it. And you take the blood. Let me give us 30 seconds to do that. And we come back. Yes, let's take that. As you are taking that, let's not forget by the special grace of God. Tonight we shall be having our Fiji. Amen. Not last night, 2 nights ago, we have one. Amen. Imagine, I call it emergency Fiji. Amen. For those of us who are not aware, I'm sorry. It's just an emergency. Amen. Tonight we'll be coming back again for that prayer warfare recovery part two. 2 nights ago was recovery part one. Tonight is going to be part two. Amen. Listen to me. You must recover everything which the enemy has taken from you in the name of Jesus. And I know the power of the Almighty God will be available tonight in the name of Jesus. Amen. It's not going to be on Facebook. It's going to be on conference call app. Amen. Just download the conference call app from your app store and you'll find it. Or you want me to send you the link, just send me a message. You can see my number on the screen, +234 806268 6255. The Lord bless us in the name of Jesus. And for those of us who partner with me on this assignment, I pray for each and every one of you. The Lord will lift you up. The Lord bless you in the name of Jesus. As many of you who always send in your seed, your tithe, your offering, the Lord will raise helpers for you in the name of Jesus. You never know a better yesterday in the name of Jesus. This season, the dew of heaven will fall upon your life, your marriage, your business, your career in the name of Jesus. And for those of us who are saying, Pastor, me too, I must be blessed. You are blessed in the name of Jesus. For those of us who want to join those who partner with him, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. You can see my phone number on the screen, +234 806268 6255. Why don't you send me a message after this program for a candidate and I will send them to you. God bless us in the name of Jesus. Are we ready for our prayer? Thank you, Jesus. I said, are we ready? Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. Let's lift up our hand and begin to plead the blood of Jesus upon ourselves. Say, I plead the blood of Jesus upon myself, upon my spirit, soul, and body. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. Upon myself, spirit, soul, and body. The blood of Jesus. 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 Upon myself, upon my spirit, upon my soul, upon my body, upon my marriage. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. Plead the blood of Jesus upon your spirit, soul, and body. The blood, 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 the blood of Jesus. 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 In Jesus' name we have decreed. Listen, the Bible says we overcome by the blood of Jesus. Am I right? We overcome by the blood of Jesus. Revelation 11 said, we overcome him by the blood of Jesus. So you are going to decree and declare. Say in the name of Jesus, Say by the blood of Jesus, I overcome every stubborn problem in my life. In the name of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus, every stubborn problem, stubborn challenges, every issues, negative issues in my life, in my marriage, I overcome them. By the blood of Jesus, I overcome them. By the blood of Jesus, I overcome them. By the blood of Jesus, every negative issue, every negative circumstances, every challenges in my life, in my marriage, in my business, in my career, I overcome you. By the blood of Jesus, 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 in Jesus' name we have decreed. In Jesus' name we have decreed. Say this after me. Say in the name of Jesus. Say, paralyzed, all satanic oppressors, delegated against me, against my life, against my marriage, against my business, against my career. Say in the name of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus, I paralyze every activities or oppressor. In the name of Jesus, I paralyze them. 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 Every oppressor, every activity or oppressor, I paralyze them. In Jesus' name, we have decreed. In Jesus' name, we have decreed. Amen. Listen to this next prayer. You are going to decree and declare. You lift up your hand, which signifies you are lifting up the blood of Jesus. Say in the name of Jesus. Say by the blood of Jesus, I redeem my life. I redeem my life. I redeem my marriage. I redeem my health. I redeem my marriage, my finance. In the name of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus, I redeem them from satanic attack, from the hold of hell, from hold of Satan, from manipulation. I redeem them. In the name of Jesus, what area of your life do you want to redeem? Begin to mention them. Is it your finance? Redeem your finance. Redeem your bank account from the hold of poverty. In the name of Jesus, what about your body organ? Redeem your body organ from the hold of sickness. In the name of Jesus, what about your life? From the hold of hardship, redeem your life. Say by the blood of Jesus, I redeem my life in the name of Jesus from the hold of Satan, from the hold of wickedness. I redeem my life. I redeem my home. I redeem my marriage. I redeem my business. I redeem my career in the name of Jesus. By the blood of Jesus, I redeem my life. In the name of Jesus, you my life, you my marriage, you my business, you my career, you my finance, you my health, my wife, my children, your husband. Say by the blood of Jesus, my finance, my bank account, I redeem you from the hold of darkness. In the name of Jesus, from failure, from setback, I redeem my life. In the name of Jesus, begin to redeem your life. By that blood of Jesus, that blood of Jesus, that blood of Jesus, that blood of Jesus, redeem your life, redeem your marriage, redeem your life, redeem your business, redeem your life, redeem your health, by the blood of Jesus, that 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 blood of Jesus, in Jesus' name we have decreed. Do you know the next prayer we are going to pray? You are going to decree and declare, I flush out of my life. The Bible said, I will cleanse their blood that I have not cleansed. You remember this, the scripture from the book of Zechariah. It said, I will cleanse their blood that I have not been cleansed. What are those negative vices in your life? What are the things that your father suffer? What are the things that your mother suffer? What are the things that your parents suffer? What are those characters in your life, in the life of your parents? What about you? What about your mother? What about your husband? What are the character deficiency in the life of your husband that you can now see their traits in the life of your children and you know that these things are not right? So you are going to decree and declare, say by the blood of Jesus, see, I purge my life from every unwanted thing in the name of Jesus. Say by the blood of Jesus, see, I purge my life, my marriage, my business, my career from every of negative vices in the name of Jesus. Negative character, unwanted issue, unwanted circumstances in the name of Jesus. See, I flush them out in the name of Jesus. I purge my life, my marriage, my business, my career, my spouse, my wife, your husband, our children. Say we purge our life in the name of Jesus by the blood of Jesus. Say you my life. I purge you with the blood of Jesus. My marriage, I purge you with the blood of Jesus. My business, I purge you by the blood of Jesus. Why don't you begin to purge your life, your marriage, your business with the blood of Jesus? The blood of Jesus. 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 Thank you, Father. Jesus' name we have decreed. In Jesus' name we have decreed. The Bible said that we and I, we are justified. You and I, we are justified by the blood of Jesus. We are justified to receive the due of heaven. We talk about the blessings of God. You and I, we are justified for lifting, for promotion. Though the enemy may be saying, no, you are not qualified. But the Bible says we are justified. That means we are qualified. So you are going to decree and declare, what are the testimony? What are the breakthrough that you are expecting from God? You are going to decree and declare, say in the name of Jesus, I, Oreoluwa Ariola, I am justified for lifting, for promotion, for testimony, for breakthrough, for fruitfulness. I am justified in the name of Jesus. I am justified to receive them in the name of Jesus. I am justified to receive divine blessing, to receive divine promotion. I am justified in the name of Jesus. I am justified. My marriage is justified. My business is justified. This ministry is justified. Praying good is justified. Praying good academy is justified. Prayer avalanche is justified. Each and every one of you online right now, all those of you that are listening to this podcast, you are justified to be promoted. You are justified to for lifting. You are justified for promotion. You are justified for lifting, for breakthrough, for testimony. You are justified for all-round fruitfulness. You are justified in the name of Jesus. Why not decree and declare it? Mention those areas. Say, I'm justified by the blood of Jesus. I am 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 justified by the blood of Jesus. Thank you, mighty Father. Jesus' name we have decreed. Listen to me. The Bible said the blood of Jesus Christ speaketh better than the blood of what? The blood of Abel. The blood of Abel speaks accusation, allegation, destroy, condemn, judge, bring him down. Amen. But the blood of Jesus Christ speaking what? Better things. Oh, my daughter, this is your system of lifting. Oh, my son, this is your system of divine settlement. You are going to decree and declare. Say by the blood of Jesus. Say in the name of Jesus. Say from today, blood of Jesus, begin to speak better things into my life, to my marriage, to my business, to my career. Blood of Jesus, speak lifting, speak promotion, speak enlargement, speak healing, speak breakthrough, speak fruitfulness. In the name of Jesus, what do you want the blood of Jesus Christ to speak for you? What do you want the blood of Jesus Christ to speak for you? Begin to mention them in the name of Jesus. Let the blood of Jesus, let him speak lifting, promotion, enlargement, in the name of Jesus, fruitfulness, in the name of Jesus, breakthrough, marital breakthrough, ministerial breakthrough, academic breakthrough, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, mighty Father. In Jesus' name we have decreed. In Jesus' name we have decreed. Say today, say I create a boundary against devil and his atrocity in the name of Jesus. Say concerning my life, concerning my marriage, concerning my business, concerning my career, say I create a boundary by the blood of Jesus against devil and his atrocity, against devil and his host. I create a boundary for my life, my marriage, my business, my career, by the blood of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' name we have decreed. In Jesus' name we have decreed. Say in the name of Jesus, say by the blood of Jesus, say I render evil power militating against me, my marriage, my business, my career, my lifting, my progress. I say in the name of Jesus, say I declare them impotent in the name of Jesus. Say I render them impotent in the name of Jesus. Any satanic power militating against me, against my lifting, against my promotion, against my testimony, I render them useless. I render them impotent. In the name of Jesus, satanic power lifted up, satanic altar raised against me, against my life, against my marriage. Any satanic mouth that is causing me, causing this ministry, causing the work of my hand, I render them impotent. In the name of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus, I render them impotent. In the name of Jesus, thank you, mighty Father. Say in the name of Jesus, say I plead the blood of Jesus against spirit of stagnation in any area of my life. In the name of Jesus, say that spirit of stagnation in my life, in my marriage, in my business, in my career. I plead the blood of Jesus against you. In the name of Jesus, I plead the blood of Jesus against you. In the name of Jesus, I plead the blood of Jesus against you. In the name of Jesus, say in the name of Jesus, say I plead the blood of Jesus against demonic delay in any area of my life. In the name of Jesus, the blood of Jesus against spirit of delay. In the name of Jesus, demonic delay. I plead the blood of Jesus against you. In the name of Jesus, concerning my lifting, concerning my promotion, concerning my testimony, concerning my breakthrough, the blood of Jesus, I plead it against delay, against failure, in the name of Jesus. Why not begin to plead the blood of Jesus against failure at the edge of success, in the name of Jesus. Every failure at the edge of success, slippery breakthrough, reoccurring slippery breakthrough, in the name of Jesus. Plead the blood of Jesus against them. The blood of Jesus, 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 the blood of Jesus. Plead the blood of Jesus against them, against slippery breakthrough. In Jesus' name we have decreed. Thank you, Jesus. One of the prophecies, I'm hearing something like that again. One of the prophecies for this. Hear me, one of the prophecies for this edition. God is saying, I will save your children. That's a child in the house. That's a parent in the house. One of your children is giving you concern. One of your children is giving you concern. His attitude, his character, many things about him is giving you concern. Hear me and hear me very well. By the blood of Jesus, the Lord will save that child. The Lord will deliver that child. The Lord will save that child. The Lord will deliver that child. In the name of Jesus. Any manipulation that enter into his life from his father's house. Any manipulation. I'm seeing. Any manipulation that enter into his life from his father's house. Today, by the blood of Jesus. And him come to that manipulation in the life of that child in the name of Jesus. That child is your boy. And him come to it in the name of Jesus. Whatever, according to the book of Isaiah, said in that day, shall the word, the name that has been fastened to sure places shall be removed. Anything that they have hung in your mother-in-law's place, and the more they hang it, is having negative effect on your husband and on your children. Today, I decree and declare, anything that satanically hung, let heaven remove it in the name of Jesus. Let heaven remove it in the name of Jesus. Let heaven remove it in the name of Jesus. We are going to take that prayer one more time. Say, but I plead the blood of Jesus against failure at the edge of success. I plead the blood of Jesus against slippery breakthrough in the name of Jesus. The blood 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 of Jesus. Now begin to plead the blood of Jesus against satanic prophecy, negative prediction, negative curses, negative spoken word against you, your life, your marriage, your business, your career. Begin to plead the blood of Jesus against them. Say, I plead the blood of Jesus against any word, negative word that ever spoken, that anybody ever spoken, any negative prophecy against me, my life, my marriage, my business, my career, the blood of Jesus, 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 the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' name we are decreeing. Now begin to plead the blood of Jesus against slow movement, slow progress, slow movement. What you are supposed to achieve within a month is taking you 2 years, 3 years to achieve them. Begin to plead the blood of Jesus against them in the name of Jesus. Slow movement, total spirit. Plead the blood of Jesus against them. The blood of Jesus. 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 Thank you, mighty Father. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' name we have decreed. In Jesus' name we have decreed. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. Zechariah 9, verse 11. We are delivered by the blood of Jesus. What are those things in your life today that you want God to deliver you from, mention them before the living God and ask the Lord God to deliver you from them in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Fruitless effort. Hatred. Let the Lord God deliver you from them in the name of Jesus. Thank you, mighty Father. Jesus' name we have decreed. As many of you are online this hour, that you are believing God for supernatural healing, there's issue with your health, medically you are having issue, spiritually you are having health issue, I decree, I declare. Jeremiah said, heal me, O Lord, I shall be healed. Save me, I shall be saved, for thou art my praise. Today, healing for issues of the living God, through the blood of Jesus, enter into your bloodstream in the name of Jesus. Any sickness, any ailment, any infirmity in your bloodstream, inherited sickness, inherited infirmity, in the name of Jesus, or the one they program into your life through dream, or the one that enter into your life through the hair, or through food, or through sex, in the name of Jesus, today, by the blood of Jesus, let them be purged out in the name of Jesus. Let them be purged out in the name of Jesus. Any attack on your leg, in order for you not to have progress, I'm hearing attack on leg. In order for you, spiritually, they have amputated your leg. And the reason is this, they don't want you to make progress in life. Today, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, any attack on your leg, that talk about attack on your speed of achievement, today, let the heaven intervene in the name of Jesus. Let the blood of Jesus deliver you in the name of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus, from that spiritual amputation. You are delivered. In the name of Jesus, I speak to that woman. Your business will prosper. Your business will not crash. Your business will not fail in the name of Jesus. Your business will prosper in the name of Jesus. Any loopholes in your life where enemy are draining virtues out, today by the blood of Jesus, let heaven seal them up in the name of Jesus. Thank you, mighty Father. I pray for those of us who are believing God for fruit of the womb in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Let the Lord God breathe upon you the breath of life. The breath of life in the name of Jesus, the power of the highest for you to conceive and for you to give birth. Let it come upon you now. In Jesus' name, we have decreed. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. Let's stretch our hand toward the screen. That means all this prayer requests. As I said, if you have sent in your prayer requests, be assured that you have them here. If you are not sending them in, you want to send in me. Share this this page. You see the link there. Amen. Or send me a message on that same number and I will send you the link. Amen. Are we ready? Ecclesiastes 11:3. If the heaven be full of rain, it helped them. Your heaven, my heaven, our heaven today is full of testimony and it must help them to our life. Say in the name of Jesus. I can hear you, my sister. Say in the name of Jesus. Say, Father, release testimony in the name of Jesus. Concerning all these prayer requests, say by your mercy, Father, release testimony in the name of Jesus. By your mercy, release testimony. Let there be rain of testimony. Let there be dew of testimony. Let it fall. Dew of testimony. Let it fall in the name of Jesus. Thank you, mighty Father. Jesus' name we have decreed. Once again, I pray for each and every one of you online right now. Let the hand of the Lord God for perfection, let it rest upon you. Today, as you have been part of today's testimony, today's communal service, the power, the enablement in the blood of Jesus, let it begin to speak for you in the name of Jesus. The Bible said the blood of Jesus can speak it better. From today, let the blood of Jesus begin to speak better thing in your life. Begin to speak better thing in your marriage. Begin to speak better thing in everything about you in the name of Jesus. Thank you, mighty Father. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' name, we have decreed. In Jesus' name, we have decreed. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. By the grace of God, let's not forget, tonight we are coming back for our Fiji. Amen. Hear me. I don't want the devil to like it. Because if the devil like it, that means the thing is not good. The devil don't like good things. So let the devil not like it. By fire, by force, by the right hand of God, by the mercy of God, you will possess your possession in the name of Jesus, your benefit, your right. Amen. What you're supposed to enjoy, what by now, what's supposed to be enjoyed, but the enemy has denied you of it. The enemy has denied you your benefits, your right. Tonight, this week, this weekend, this month, it shall be released in the name of Jesus. Amen. So join me tonight for our weekly Fiji, amen, on conference call up. God bless us in the Jesus name. As we go, I ask, let the hand of the Almighty God be upon us in the name of Jesus. Once again, I pray for each and every one of you who support me on this assignment. May the heaven support you. May heaven support your household. May heaven support your generation to generation in Jesus' name. Once again, God bless you all in Jesus' name.